Moscow's war against Kyiv could drag on for a long time. That's according to Russian President Vladimir Putin in a rare acknowledgement of the duration of the war he started more than 9 months ago. In a televised meeting, Putin also warned the risk of a nuclear war is growing. That's the latest in a string of warnings from Putin in an apparent attempt to deter Kyiv's Western backers to become more involved. Meanwhile, Putin said there will be no second call-up for soldiers for now. In September, a growing Ukrainian counteroffensive prompted Moscow to announce a partial mobilization of conscripts. Time magazine has named Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky, as well as the Spirit of Ukraine, as its 2022 Person of the Year. The magazine hailed Zelensky's courage, which it said spread through Ukraine's political leadership in the first days of the Russian invasion. According to Time's editor-in-chief, that courageous spirit has also been embodied by the countless individuals inside and outside the country fighting behind the scenes. For the magazine, Zelensky shifted the geopolitical system, galvanizing the world in a way that has not been seen in decades. The Taliban in Afghanistan carry out the first public execution since taking over the country. The hardline Islamist group said a man convicted of murder was publicly executed by shooting, with the victim's father carrying out the sentence. The suspect had allegedly killed the man's son and stole his motorcycle and cell phone. The United Nations and the U.S. have denounced the public execution, with Washington calling it despicable.
This indicates to us that the Taliban seek a return to their regressive and abusive practices of the 1990s. It was an affront to the dignity and human rights of all Afghans then. It would be an affront to the dignity and the human rights of all Afghans now.
The hard-hitting program of slain broadcaster Percy Lapid back on air. Lapid's brother, veteran journalist Roy Mabasa, has taken over as host. The much-anticipated first episode took a shot at the alleged mastermind behind Lapid's assassination, suspended Prisons Bureau Chief Gerald Bantag. Mabasa said Bantag's motion to have the Justice Department inhibit from the murder case is his way of delaying the proceedings and preventing an arrest warrant from being issued against him. Lapid's children also appeared as guests and talked about how they are coping months after their father's death. The World Bank calls on the Philippine government to increase spending on agriculture. The global lender says food security will be critical for poverty reduction efforts in the Philippines. It adds, aside from the clear benefit of improving local food supply to reduce inflation, the sector is also responsible for roughly one quarter of employment in the Philippines. The World Bank says it's quite surprising that the sector has been receiving relatively smaller budget from the government compared with other agencies.
Agriculture's share in the total budget has been consistently declining. We are very positive and hopeful seeing the FY23 budget where the spending has gone up. But overall, analyzing the past trend, it has declined from 2.6% in 2015 to 1.3% in 2019, which is pretty low. There is a lot of emphasis on commodity-based banner program, out of which obviously the National Rice Program dominates that banner program. Even there, a large part of support is going against on the production level support, subsidizing the sector, which are not really generating results.
The Agriculture Department's budget for 2023 is set at over 179 billion pesos, a nearly 40% increase from its 2022 funding.